The attorney's letter came as a deep shock to me. My Uncle Jeremy had died by his own hand. The coroner's report was unequivocal. He hanged himself in the loft. My initial surprise and distress passed. I considered the news. It seemed clear that Derceto had exercised a thoroughly morbid influence on my uncle's mind. Oh.
Fragment of the Myth of the Golden Fleece. Translation, Edouard de Villeban. Hesperides Publications. Fragment of the Myth of the...
Then, Perseus came across Ichios, who had been turned into stone. He spoke to his companions and said, "Beware of the Medusa. He who looks into their eyes is doomed to the same fate as that which befell poor Ichios, and will never more set eyes on Seriphos." "Must we go blindfolded?" asked Eumolpus. "Take up your bronze shields and polish them until they flash in the sun," answered Perseus. "Fill your hearts with courage. May Artemis guide us as though we were an arrow from her quiver." But Eumolpus was not satisfied. "Why do that, Perseus? Is 3 inches of sharpened metal not enough to destroy these accursed creatures?" Then Perseus drew his sword, which shone and glittered in the sun, and with it he dazzled Eumolpus. "Now what can you see?" the companions of Zeus' sons laughed. "Let us set to work so that our shields may shine like mirrors."
The attorney's letter came as a deep shock.
Thank you.
The attorney.
Ugh. Oh.
the Eternal.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Fragment of the Myth of the Golden Fleece. Translation, Edouard Villeban. Hesperides Publications.
Then, Perseus came across Ichios, who had been turned into stone. He spoke to his companions and said, "Beware of the Medusa. He who looks into their eyes is doomed to the same fate as that which befell poor Ichios, and will never more set eyes on Seraphos." "Must we go blindfolded?" asked Eumolpus. "Take up your bronze shields and polish them until they flash in the sun," answered Perseus. "Fill your hearts with courage. May Artemis guide us as though we were an arrow from her." quiver. But Eumolpus was not satisfied. "Why do that, Perseus? Is 3 inches of sharpened metal not enough to destroy these accursed creatures?" Then Perseus drew his sword, which shone and glittered in the sun, and with it he dazzled Eumolpus. "Now what can you see?" the companions of Zeus' sons laughed. "Let us set to work so that our shields may shine like mirrors."